Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The House will come to order. Excited today because our Pledge of Allegiance will be led by Allie Puglisi from Timberview Middle School and Dominic Puglisi from Trail Elementary School, both from Colorado Springs.
Now please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Woo! Mr. Schiebel, please call the roll.
Representative Amabile. Rep. Amabile.
Excused.
Armagost. Bacon. Byrd. Representative Byrd.
Excused.
Bockenfeld.
Excused.
Basenecker. Rep. Basenecker.
Excused.
Bottoms. Bradfield. Bradley. Brown. Catlin. Clifford. Doherty. Representative Doherty. Doherty's excused. DeGraff. Degree Kennedy. Duran. English. Epps. Evans. Frizzell. Froelich. Garcia. Hamrick. Hartsook. Hernandez. Herod. Representative Herod. Herod's excused. Holtorf. Judah.
Here.
Joseph. Kip. Leader. Representative Leader. Leader's excused. Lindsay. Lindsay. Lindstead. Luck.
Here.
Lukens. Rep. Lukens. Okay. Lukens is excused. Lynch. Mabry. Marshall. Martinez. Marvin. Morrow. McCormick. McLaughlin. Ortiz.
Here.
Parenti. Puglisi. Ricks. Rutinell. It's here. Sirota. Snyder. Soper. Rep. Soper's excused. Story. It's here. Taggart. Rep. Taggart is excused. Titone. Valdez A. Representative Valdez. Valdez is excused. Velasco. Vigil. Weinberg. Weissman. Wilford is excused. Wilson. Winter. Woodrow. Rep. Woodrow is excused. Young and Madam Speaker.
With 54 present, 11 excused, we do have a quorum. Representative Hernandez.
Good morning, Madam Speaker. It's an honor to serve with you.
Honor to serve with you.
Good morning, members. Today, I just want to take a brief moment. I've been talking about some people's history here in the People's House. I want to take a moment to remind us of a story of 1968 when Lupe Briceño and seven other Kiriyama Carnation Plant workers organized a strike against the Kiriyama Carnation Plant. It was the first time that floral workers and agricultural workers organized a union here in the state of Colorado. Next week, we're going to hear about the Cesar Chavez announcement, but want to remind us that the work here for farm workers and unions was started and began by women who eventually chained themselves to the entrance and were tear gassed by police. So with that, Madam Speaker, I move that the Journal of Tuesday, March 26, 2024 be approved as corrected by the Chief Clerk.
The motion before us is the adoption of the journal as approved and corrected by the Chief Clerk. Whoops. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. The ayes have it. The motion is adopted. Announcements. Representative Amabile.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. March is Problem Gambling Awareness Month. And in that light, today, March 27th, is Problem Gambling Awareness Day here at the Capitol. It's hosted by the Colorado Division of Gaming and the Colorado Lottery. And they would love for you guys to stop by the first floor rotunda, grab breakfast, and learn about what's being done in Colorado to promote responsible gaming and available resources. I represent Gilpin County, where a lot of the gaming happens, and it's fun to do, but for some people it can be really problematic, and so I hope you'll all pay attention to that. And I did leave something on your desks. Thanks.
Representative McLaughlin.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Education Committee, we are meeting today. We start off with House Bill 1068, then we go to Senate Bill 104, then we go to Senate Bill 70, and we round up with House Bill 24-1167. See you there.
Assistant Minority Leader Winter.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I just want to let you all know that Enterprise Mobility invites us all to their breakfast at the Capitol tomorrow morning, 7:30 a.m. to 9 a.m., the 28th, outside the old Supreme Court chambers. They'd love to see you there. Thank you.
Representative English.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members, today I wanted to welcome to the People's House Chamber, a group of individuals that are here for Black Student Advocacy Day in collaboration with the Center for Advancing Black Excellence in Education, and they are representing over 10 different organizations that directly impact the lives of our Black students throughout the state. So you all can stand and we recognize them. Thank you.
Representative Weinberg.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. It's an honor to serve with you.
Honor to serve with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, God is in the building today. I'm sorry. I would like to present to you our ministry leaders and leaders of faith from Larimer County. If you could be recognized in the gallery and on the side there, please stand and be recognized by the House Chambers.
Representative Amabile.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Today we will be having business and labor, and we will be meeting today in the old state library instead of our usual spot. We will be hearing three bills, 1351, 1353, and Senate Bill 66. I'll see you at 1:30. Thanks.
Thank you. Representative Kipp, do you have an announcement? I have two announcements. Representative Marvin will replace Representative Wilford on the Energy and Environment Committee for today only. Representative Brown will replace Representative Leader on the Business Affairs and Labor Committee for today only. Representative Kipp.
Thank you, Madam Chair, or Madam Speaker. Let me find it here. So Energy and Environment will unusually be meeting today at 1:30 p.m. to hear 1173, 1346, 1359. We will be across the street in LSBA.
Thank you. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to lay over the balance of the calendar to Thursday, March 28, 2024.
Seeing no objection, the balance of the calendar will be laid over until Thursday, March 28, 2024. Please proceed, Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move that the House stand in recess until later today.
Seeing no objection, the House will stand in recess until later today.